Hello everyone, welcome to the today's lecture where we are going to learn about the dispersal of plant pathogens part 2, that is passive or indirect dispersal. Here we are going to learn. In my previous lecture I covered about the direct dispersal of plant pathogens. Let us see some introduction about the dispersal of plant pathogens. And dissemination or dispersal of plant pathogens, this is the second link in the infection chain. There are two links in the infection chain, that is, first one is the survival through dormant structures and the second one dispersal of plant pathogens, and these two links are very closely bound with each other. Actually, the dormant structures, that is the fungus which produces some dormant structures, they provide the means of dispersal in time, that is, the pathogen is retained viable over a period of time, enabling that pathogen to be transported through physical agencies without being harmed. So fungal pathogens or bacterial pathogens which used to be produce dormant structures, this dormant structures is a mean of dispersal in particular time without harming itself, that fungus remain viable. Fungus or bacteria or any pathogen which produces dormant structures, they remain viable over a particular time. And there are two modes of dispersal, what I already discussed in my previous lecture. First one is the autonomous or direct or active dispersal, and second one is indirect or passive dispersal. Let us see the difference between the direct dispersal and indirect dispersal. In case of direct dispersal, plant pathogens disperse through the soil, seed and planting material during the normal agronomic operations, and there is no major role for the external agencies like insects, wind, water in direct dispersal. Whereas in indirect dispersal, which is also known as passive dispersal, the plant pathogens disperse through the animate and inanimate agents. So what are animate and inanimate agents? Animate agents means include insects, mites, fungus, nematodes, human beings, phanerogamic parasites, birds, farm and wild animals. Whereas inanimate agents include wind and water. Dispersal by wind is also known as anemochory, and dispersal by the water is also known as hydrochory. Let us see the examples of the pathogens which are dispersed by individual these animate agents and inanimate. Coming to the first animate agent, that is insects. Insects, they used to carry the plant pathogens either externally, that is epizootic, or internally, which is also known as endozootic. And these insects can disseminate various kinds of plant pathogens like bacteria, fungi, viruses, mycoplasmas, spiroplasmas, rickettsia, etc. So let us see the examples which are dispersed by these insects. Fungal diseases. Fungal diseases, the external transmission is of special interest in those fungi generally which produces conidia, oidia and spermatia in honey secretions which are having the attractive colors. That means fungi used to produce conidia, oidia and spermatia along with some honeydew secretions. Because of that smell produced from these honeydew secretions, they will attract the different type of insects which helps in dispersal of these plant pathogens. Example for these fungal diseases which are transmitted by the insects are, first one is the sugary disease of sorghum caused by Spirillia sorghum. Here the spermatial oozings at the mouth of Spermogonia. Spermogonia is a structure produced in the ascomycetes. It will attract the various type of insects like flies, pollinating bees like honey bees and wasps, which play a dual role. Here what they will do, they do pollination and also helps in transmission of plant pathogens. If you are not going to understand about this Spermogonia structure, just to go through my previous lecture, so here you can understand the different type of rooting bodies produced in ascomycetes fungi. And second disease is Dutch elm disease caused by Ceratostomella elmi. This Dutch elm disease is transmitted internally by elm bark beetles belonging to the genus Scolytus. Here in this picture you can see sugary disease of sorghum, which produces honeydew secretions that will attract the various insects. And Dutch elm disease caused by Ophiostoma novaealmi, this is transmitted by the elm, this beetle. And bacterial diseases which are transmitted by the insects are fire blight organism, that is fire blight disease caused by the bacteria Erwinia amylovera. This bacterium is transmitted by flies and ants. And second disease, citrus canker bacterium, which is caused by Xanthomonas axenopodis pathoversitri. This citrus canker bacterium, this is transmitted by the leaf miner Phyllonictis citrella. And cucumber wilt bacterium, that caused by the Erwinia trachophila. This cucumber wilt bacterium is spread by the two types of beetles. One is a striped cucumber beetle, that is Ecalima vittata, and the spotted cucumber beetle Diabrotica undecimi punctata. When these beetles are feeding on the diseased plants, that is cucumber wilt infected the cucumber plants, bacterium contaminate the mouth parts of these beetles and it passes through the gut of the beetle, and where it overwinters inside the beetle during the winter season. So here beetles playing two roles, that is helps in survival of that particular bacterium and also transmission of that bacterium. These are the examples of the bacterial diseases which are transmitted by the insects. Here you can see fire blight disease caused by Erwinia amylovera, and citrus canker caused by Xanthomonas citri, which is transmitted by the leaf miner, and bacterial wilt Erwinia trachophila, which is transmitted by the two types of beetles, that is striped cucumber beetle and spotted cucumber beetle. Now let us see the viral diseases which are transmitted by the various insects. More than 80% of the viral and phytoplasmal diseases are spread by different type of insects. Here in viral diseases spread, insects play a very important role. And insects which acts as a specific carriers in disseminating the diseases are called insect vectors. Here this term we have to remember, that is insect vectors. Means insects which act as a specific carriers for disseminating the diseases. These are called insect vectors. And especially the insects like aphids, which belongs to the family Aphididae, and leaf hoppers belongs to the family Cycadellidae or Jacidae in the order Homoptera. They contain largest number and most important insect vectors of plant viruses. Means mainly aphids and leaf hoppers, they will transmit most of the viral diseases. In certain species of mealybugs and scale insects, which belongs to the family Coccoidae, and white flies belongs to the family Ailurodidae, and tree hoppers belongs to the family Membrasidae, in Homoptera they can also transmit some viral diseases. And insect vectors of plant viruses also present in other groups like true bugs in Hemiptera, and thrips in the order Thesanoptera, beetles and Coleoptera, and grasshoppers, Orthoptera, they will also able to transmit some viral diseases. So let us see individually about these insects, what they are going to transmit, which type of viral diseases. First one, we will see about the aphid transmitted viruses. Here I am listing some aphid species which can able to transmit some of the viral diseases. First one is Myges persicae. This is the aphid which can capable of transmitting viral diseases like beet mosaic, beet yellows, and lettuce mosaic, potato virus 5, and turnip mosaic diseases. And second aphid, Azithosiphon pisum, it can capable of transmitting bean common mosaic, bean yellow mosaic, soybean mosaic, and pea nation mosaic diseases. And Toxoptera citricidus, it will transmit the citrus distichia virus. These are the aphid transmitted viruses. Coming to the second category, leaf hopper transmitted viruses. Rice tungro disease, which is caused by rice tungro virus. This virus is transmitted by the leaf hoppers, that is Nephotetics impicticeps and Nephotetics nigropictus and Nephotetics virescens. And rice dwarf disease caused by rice dwarf virus. This virus is transmitted by the leaf hoppers Nephotetics scinticeps and Nephotetics nigropictus. And beet curly top virus, which causes beet curly top disease. This disease is transmitted by the leaf hopper Circulifer tenellus, and Agalia contracta, it can capable of transmitting potato yellow dwarf virus, and Graminella nigrifrons transmits maize chlorotic dwarf virus. These five are the some of the examples where leaf hoppers will transmit the different viruses. Now coming to the third category, where tree hopper transmitted viruses, Microtalis mellifera, tree hopper capable of transmitting tomato pseudo curly top disease caused by tomato pseudo curly top virus. And plant hopper transmitted viruses, Peregrinus meides, which can transmit maize mosaic, and Sorghatoads or Rizicola, which will capable of transmitting rice hoja blanca. And fifth category, whitefly transmitted viruses. This is the very important whitefly transmitted diseases. And Bemisia tobaci, this is the most important species which can capable of transmitting more viral diseases, especially Bendy yellowveen mosaic, Bendy leaf curl, Chili leaf curl, Cotton leaf curl, Papaya leaf curl, and Mungbean yellow mosaic virus. And sixth category, thrips transmitted viruses. Thrips like thrips tabaci, Franklinella schoolgi, and Sitothrips dorsalis, these three thrips used to transmit cocoa swollen shoot disease. And second thrip, that is Pseudococcus saccharifolia, it can capable of transmitting sugarcane spike disease, which is caused by the phytoplasma. And grasshopper transmitted viruses are grasshopper melanophus differentialis. It can capable of transmitting the diseases like potato virus X and tobacco mosaic virus. But main mode of transmission for tobacco mosaic virus is the mechanical transmission. And another category is lace bugs transmitted viruses, that is Piasma quadratum. It can capable of transmitting beet leaf curl virus, and Stephanitis typicus, root wilt disease of coconut caused by the phytoplasma. Beetle transmitted viruses, Ceratoma triforcata, it can capable of transmitting cowpea mosaic virus, and squash mosaic virus transmitted by Ecalima trivittata, and broom mosaic virus transmitted by Diabrotica longicornis. These are the various viral diseases transmitted by varial insect. And mycoplasmal diseases which are transmitted by various insects are generally plant mycoplasmal like organism. They used to situated in the phloem inhabitants. They used to locate in the phloem. So insects which can capable of piercing up to the phloem, then they can capable of transmitting these mycoplasmal diseases. So plant mycoplasma like organisms are phloem inhabitants, and those insects which are feeding on phloem of the plants, they can capable of transfer these MLOs. And mycoplasmal diseases are mostly transmitted by leaf hoppers, because leaf hoppers are the phloem eaters. They used to pierce until up to the phloem, then they obtain nutrients from the phloem tissue. Examples for the mycoplasmal diseases which are transmitted by the insects are Sesamum phyllodi, Orosius albicinctus, and little leaf of brinjal, Hishimonas physetes. And mites. Mites belonging to the families Eriophidae, like Eriophid mite, and Tetranychidae of the class Arachnida, they can transmit plant viruses. So in previous session, first one, we covered about the insects which can capable of transmitting varial diseases caused by fungi, bacteria, viruses, and mycoplasmas. And second category under animate agents is the mites. Mites belonging to the family Eriophidae and Tetranychidae, under the class Arachnida, they can transmit the plant viruses. Genera Abacarus, Azaria, Eriophis, and Brevipulpus, these are the important genera of the mites which can capable of transmitting the plant pathogens. Let us see few examples. Aseria kajani, it transmits Pigeon P. sterility mosaic virus, and Aseria tulipae transmits wheat streak mosaic virus. Coming to the fungi which can act as a vectors for transmitting various plant pathogens, especially fungi will transmit the some of the viral diseases. Let us see what are those. Some soil-borne fungal plant pathogens carry the plant viruses in or on their resting spores and juice spores. So in such a way they will transmit them from the susceptible host to the healthy plants during the infection process. Example, tobacco necrosis virus TNV and cucumber mosaic virus that is CMV, these two are carried outside the fungi, whereas Lettuce bigwin mosaic virus, this is carried inside the juice pores. So tobacco necrosis virus and cucumber mosaic virus, these are carried outside the fungi, and Lettuce bigwin virus, this is carried inside the juice pores. And many soil borne viruses, these are transmitted by members of chytridials and plasmodiophorales. And now let us see some of the examples where fungal pathogens can capable of transmitting some viral diseases. Aulpidium brassicae, it can capable of transmitting tobacco necrosis, tobacco stunt virus and Lettuce bigwin virus. Aulpidium cucurbitacearum in cucumber necrosis virus, and Polymyxa graminis, barley yellow dwarf mosaic, wheat soil borne mosaic, peanut clump virus, and Polymyxa beetae, beet necrotic yellowbean virus, and Spongospora subterranea, it can transmit potato mop top virus. Cinquitrium endobioticum, it will capable of transmitting potato virus X. These are the some of the examples where fungi helps in transmission of the plant viruses. And coming to the next category, nematodes, which can act as a vectors for transmitting the plant pathogens. So first we covered insects, second mites, and third fungus, fourth nematodes. So there are several nematodes which can act as a vectors for transmission of fungi, bacteria and viruses. We will see the some of the bacterial diseases which are transmitted by the nematodes. Generally we will remember association of bacterium and nematode is the yellow ear rot of wheat caused by Corynebacterium tritici or Clavibacter tritici. This bacterium is disseminated by ear cockle nematode, that is Anguina tritici. So these two are used to be associated together. If these two diseases appear together, that complex disease is known as tundu disease of wheat. So this Clavibacter tritici, it is not capable of dispersal and infection unless it is carried by Anguina tritici. So for its dispersal, it should be associated with the nematode Anguina tritici. Otherwise, it can't capable of disseminating from one place to another place. Fungal diseases, root rot and wilt pathogens such as Phytophthora, Fusarium, Rhizoctonia, Verticillium, generally these used to be present in the soil. So these are transmitted by or disseminated by the nematodes. And viral diseases, here nematodes play a vital role in transmitting certain virus diseases, especially soil borne viruses. These are used to be transmitted by the nematodes. So nematodes used to be soil inhabitants, so they can capable of transmitting the soil borne viruses. And like Xiphenema, Longidorus, Trichodorus and Paratrichodorus, these are the nematode genera belonging to Dorylamoidae. These four genera can capable of transmitting the plant viruses. So let us see what are those plant viruses transmitted by these different genera. And mainly the nematode transmitted plant viruses are divided into two groups on the basis of shape of their virus particles. Like one is Nepo viruses and Netu viruses. Nepo means nematode transmitted polyhedral viruses. Here you can see which are having the polyhedral shape. And second one is nematode transmitted tubular viruses. Here you can see which is having the tubular structure. So some nematodes can be capable of transmitting tubular viruses and some nematodes can be capable of transmitting polyhedral viruses. So what are Nepo viruses? Nepo viruses are the nematode transmitted viruses which are having polyhedral particles, and these generally transmitted by genus of Xiphenema and Longidorus. Examples of the nematode species which can capable of transmitting the viruses are tobacco ring spot virus, tomato ring spot virus, tomato black ring virus and Arabis mosaic virus. And Nitu viruses. Nitu viruses means nematode transmitted tubular viruses, that is nematode which is capable of transmitting the tubular viruses, especially by Trichodorus and Paratrichodorus. These two genera capable of transmitting these tubular viruses. Examples are the P. early Browning virus, which is transmitted by Trichodorus, and tobacco rattle virus TRV, that is transmitted by the Trichodorus pachydermis. And here we can see the list out for your easy understanding purpose, and we have to remember all these examples for examination point of view. And Paratrichodorus and Trichodorus, these two can capable of transmitting P. early Browning and tobacco rattle, which are the this tubular shape, that is NETU group. And Xiphinema index transmitting grapevine fan leaf virus, which is Nepo virus. Xiphinema americanum capable of transmitting tobacco ring spot and tomato ring spot, these also Nepo virus. And Longidorus elongatus, which used to transmit raspberry ring spot virus, this belongs to the group Nepo virus. So we have to remember all these examples. Up to now we covered about the nematode transmitting plant pathogens. Now coming to the next category, human beings, where human beings playing very important role in transmission of the plant pathogens, and how these human beings are responsible for dispersal of plant pathogens, and what are the different modes of transmission by these human beings. Let us see. First one is transportation of the seeds, that is seed trade. Import and export of the contaminated seeds without proper precautions, which can lead to movement of pathogens from one country to another or from one continent to another. This is the most important way of transmitting plant pathogens from one continent to another, because if you'll transmit the contaminated seeds without prior testing them, then plant pathogens easily transferred to another continents. And diseases which are amenable to such transmission are mainly those which are carried on the propagative parts or on the seed, that is internally seed transmission or externally seed transmission. Example for such type of pathogens are late blight of potato, downy mildew of grapevine, citrus canker disease, and fusarium wilt of banana. These diseases are easily transmitted through vegetatively propagative parts or seed material. First, this is the transportation of the seed. And second one is the planting diseased seed materials. Planting diseased like bulbs, bulbils, corms, tubers, rhizomes, cuttings, so these are vegetatively propagated materials, such as especially in case of potato, sweet potato, cassava, sugarcane, banana, and many ornamental plants like chrysanthemum, rose, if you will gladiolus, if you will take, and in case of fruit trees also, these helps in dispersal of pathogens from field to field and orchard to orchard, and also from one country to another country. It means without unknowingly, we are planting the infected bulbs, bulbils, corms, tubers, rhizomes, and cuttings, especially of these vegetatively propagated plants. This is the second way of dispersal, and third is during adoption of normal cultural practices, that is farming operations. So general human beings which used to be engaged in preparatory cultivation and during planting and during irrigation or weeding operations and pruning, they helps in dispersal of plant pathogens. So here what will happen while doing these operations, fungal spores or other external structures of the fungi, they can be carried by the workers' clothes or shoes that they were wearing and hands from plant to plant and from field to field. This is the third way of dispersal, that is during adoption of normal farm practices. And fourth one is by use of contaminated implements. This is unknowingly it is going to happen, because while using implements for farm operations, they used to come in contact with the infected plant materials, and the pathogens from that infected plant to healthy plants, they will transfer through these contaminated implements, like especially during the operations weeding, thinning, and hoeing under the field conditions. Example, soil-borne diseases such as root rot and wilt, they are easily transmitted through the contaminated implements. Cutting knives and pruning knives, which helps in dispersal from one plant to another, example in case of bunchy top of banana, in such disease, cutting knives and pruning knives helps in dispersal of plant pathogens. This is the one way. And another way is by use of diseased grafting and budding materials, especially in fruit trees where grafting and budding we used to carry out. Then when we are doing this grafting and budding between the healthy and diseased plants, so this is the most effective method of distribution of pathogens, especially for the horticultural crops like guava, mango, grapefruit, grape. And for horticultural crop, this is the most effective way of dispersal of plant pathogens. These are the different ways through by which means that human beings can capable of transmitting the helps in dispersal of the plant pathogens. Dispersal by phanerogamic parasites. Like phanerogamic parasites also, they transmit the viruses by acting as a bridge between the diseased and healthy plants. Especially if you remember, the phanerogamic parasites means we come across the most important species, that is dodder, that is Cuscuta californica and Cuscuta campestris, Cuscuta subinclusa. This Cuscuta subinclusa, it can capable of transmitting cucumber mosaic virus, and Cuscuta californica, it transmits tobacco mosaic virus, tobacco rattle virus and tomato spotted wilt virus. Cuscuta campestris transmits tomato bushy stunt virus, that is TBSV. Coming to the dispersal by birds, these are the animate agents which are capable of helps in dispersal of these plant pathogens. And birds, how these birds will capable of transmitting these plant pathogens? During the eating process, what will happen? Crows, while feeding on fleshy, sticky and gelatinous berries of game mistletoe, that is dendrophyte, they will deposit the seeds on the other trees with excreta in such a way that will transmit from one plant to another plant, because that is also a parasite. Giant mistletoe is a parasite and it depends on the other trees. And seeds of loranthus, these are disseminated by birds by sticking on their beaks and also through excreta. And if we will take the stem segments of dodder, which are carried by birds for preparing their nest and thus get transported to new areas. And the other spores of chestnut, blight fungus, Endothea parasitica, these are disseminated by more than 18 species of birds. And the Cleistothecia of many powdery mildew fungi, these are carried by feathers of birds. In such a way, birds helps in dispersal of plant pathogens. And farm and wild animals. So farm animals and wild animals, how they helps in dispersal of plant pathogens means, while doing the cultural operations or while feeding, if they are eating infected plants or the spores, they will attach to their legs and helps in so that they will transmit from one place to another place. So farm animals, while feeding on diseased fodder, ingest the viable fungal propagules, that is spores or oospores or sclerotia, and pass out such in the dung. This is the most common thing what we used to see in nature. And this dung, when used as a manure under the field conditions, and it may, this dung helps in spread of the these pathogens under the field, and it acts as a source of inoculum. Further, soil inhabiting fungi, especially sclerotia, they will adhere to the hooves and legs of animals and get transported to other places. This is the way how the farm and wild animals helps in dispersal of plant pathogens. Coming to the second category, inanimate agents. Up to now, we saw the animate agents, and now inanimate agents, that is wind and water, and how they play an important role in dispersal of the plant pathogens. First one is the wind. Dispersal of pathogens by wind is generally known as anemochory, and wind transmission involves upward air currents and velocity and downward movement of the wind. So wind act as a potent carrier of propagules of fungi, bacteria and viruses. Let us see the different examples where wind plays an important role for the dispersal of plant pathogens. In case of fungi, the fungal pathogens, generally they used to light in weight and are well adapted to wind dispersal. So what are the different adaptations present in the fungi to make them as a wind dispersal? Like fungal pathogens, they used to produce numerous spores and conidia, and discharge of these spores with a sufficient force and production of very small and lightweight spores so that they can move to the long distances. Example, powdery mildew, downy mildew, rust and smut fungi. And here wind plays an important role for the short distance dissemination and long distance dissemination. First, let us see the spores which are adapted for short distance dissemination. Sporangia of downy mildew fungi, conidia of powdery mildew fungi and basidiospores of rust fungi. Basidiospores, they are short distance dissemination. Whereas iridospores, they are long distance dissemination. Here we have to remember which spores are capable of short distance dissemination, that is sporangia of downy mildew and conidia of powdery mildew and basidiospores of rust fungi. In the plains of northern India, if you'll take annual recurrence of cereal rust that is produced by Puccinia, that is mainly due to iridospores brought by wind from source of survival in the hills in the far north, that is Himalayal and South Nilgiri areas. This iridospore is a long distance transmission. We will see spores adapted to long distance dispersal. So we have to remember the what are the spores adapted to short distance dispersal and what are the different spores adapted to long distance dispersal. For long distance dispersal, iridospores of rust fungi, chlamydospores of smut fungi and conidia of Alternaria, Helminthosporium and Pyrucularia. Uridial stage of rust fungi, if you will take, this uridial spores, they travel long distances through air currents and they are responsible for destructive epidemics over widened areas. Example, if you will take, iridospores of Puccinia graminis tritici, they were detected at as high as 14,000 feet by some of the scientists like Stackman and Christensen. And Alternaria spores, they were found at 8,000 feet above, and Puccinia recondita and Chronarchium rubicola spores at 12,500 feet above. That means they are mainly transported through the air currents. These are adapted for the long distance dissemination. And what is the dispersal distance generally for these spores? So in USA, iridospores of this Puccinia were blown from far south, that is Mexico, into Dakota and Minnesota. This is the north region and Mexico is the south region, that is traveling more than 1,000 miles in 2 days. So we can expect that how much long dissemination is possible for these spores, and that too without losing their viability. If the iridospores reach an altitude of 5,000 feet, their distance dispersal is 30 miles per hour and wind could be at 1100 miles without losing viability. So they won't lose their viability and they can capable of transmitting that much distance and can cause epidemics. And we will see the nematodes which are transmitted through the wind. Or in addition to fungi, wind also helps in the dissemination of cysts of nematodes and also seeds of phanerogamic parasites. Example, cyst of nematode which are produced by Heterodera major, which causes Molya disease of wheat and barley. These are carried by dust storms from Rajasthan to Haryana. And bacteria, some pathogenic bacteria are also carried along with the infected material to short distances by the wind. So where the wind plays an important role in dissemination of this, especially plant pathogenic bacteria, are Erwinia amylovera, that is a fire blight disease caused by this bacterium, Erwinia amylovera. Here what will happen, Erwinia amylovera produces fine strands of dried bacterial exudates from the infected stems or infected leaf tissues, which may be broken off through the wind, so that bacteria will transmit through the short distances. And viruses and phytoplasmal diseases which are transmitted by the wind are, actually there is no direct transmission, that is directly viruses and phytoplasma, they are not transmitted by the wind because they used to be present within the plant itself, that is intracellular. But how the wind plays an important role for these transmission means, especially insect vectors which are going to feed the viral and phytoplasmal infected plants, they helps in dispersal of these insects, that is moving from one place to another place, so that through that way viruses and phytoplasma also transmit from one place to another place. So there is no direct transmitted by wind, that is viruses and phytoplasmas are not directly transmitted by wind, but the insect and mite vectors carry the viruses, move to different directions and distances based on direction and speed of the air. Second one is the water. Transmission of plant pathogens by water is called hydrochory. And however, water is less important than wind in long distance transport of the pathogens, but it is more efficient as the pathogens land on wet surface and can germinate immediately. Water dissemination occurs mainly through surface running water and rain splashes. So that is, surface running water means when floods occur or during irrigation process, this will going to happen. Surface flow of water after heavy rains or during irrigation from canals and wells carry the pathogens to the short distances. Example, where water plays an important role for the short distance dissemination of plant pathogens are mycelial fragments, spores or sclerotia of the fungi, Colletotrichum falciparum, especially red rot of sugarcane, Fusarium, Ganoderma and Macrofermina, Pythium and Phytophthora, Sclerotium, these are all are transmitted through rain or irrigation water. Long distance dispersal is also possible by water only when the floods cover the larger areas or when the water flows from source of survival of pathogens to long distances. Dissemination by rain splash, this is more important especially in case of bacterial diseases, and dissemination by rain splash is known as splash dispersal, and it is one of the efficient method of dispersal of bacterial plant pathogens. So when raindrop falling with the force on the sori or pustules, cankers or even soil surface, they may splash the propagules in small droplets and enable them to land on neighboring healthy susceptible surfaces, or the water droplets may carry the long distances by the air. In this way, raindrops, that is also helps in dispersal of the plant pathogens. So examples where this rain splashes, raindrops plays an important role for transmission of the plant pathogens are bacterial leaf spot of rice caused by Xanthomonas campestris pathover varicae, bacterial leaf streak of rice caused by Xanthomonas campestris pathover varicae cola, and green ear of bajra Sclerospora graminicola. Fungal spores and bacteria which are present in the air or plant surface, these are washed downward by rain splash or drops from overhead irrigation and are deposited on susceptible healthy plants. Water not only plays an important role in dissemination of plant pathogens but also helps in growth and spore discharge of many fungi, because water is required for some of the spores produced by fungi, and also helps in spore germination and infection process also. So today, just remember, we learn about the dispersal of plant pathogens, that is indirect way or passive method through the animate agents and inanimate agents. So I think now you understood about this dispersal of plant pathogens, both mechanisms, that is direct and indirect. So thank you for your keen interest in this video, and remember to like and subscribe for more videos. If you really like this video, please share with your friends. I wish you great success, health, prosperity and happiness. Thank you.